The goal of this video is to show you how super simple it is to design and 3D print a box for a PCB. In this video, we are going to use Arduino Uno as an example, but basically what I'm going to do in this video, you can use same or very similar steps to design your own enclosure, your own box for your own PCB. In this video, we are going to use Fusion 360. They have free personal license. So basically, everyone can try it. And you will see, as I said, it's like super simple. So let's do it. Here is the video, how you can design your own box for your own PCB. Open new project in Fusion 360. Right-click, new component, call it Arduino, OK, click on Save, call it Arduino Box, Save, go to Google, search for Arduino Uno 3D model, click here, Files, download all, go back to Fusion 360, be sure Arduino component is active, click on Insert, Insert Mesh, find the STL file, what we have just downloaded, open, center, move to ground, OK, home. Go inside of Arduino, bodies, select Arduino, go to Mesh, Modify, Convert Mesh, leave everything as it is, click OK. Right click on Arduino box, new component, call it box button, OK. I'm going to hide this Arduino 3D model 3 and be sure the box button is active. Go inside of Origin, go to Solid, click on Create Sketch, and select X and Y plane. Use mouse wheel to zoom out, click on Line, zoom in, left click, draw lines around the board, left click, left click, left, escape, move this line a little bit closer, left click to select, left button hold it down and move it closer. Use offset tool, left click here, left click on the lines, and set the offset to be 2 millimeters. OK. Finish sketch. Click on Home. We are going to move the 3D model of the Arduino board a little bit up because at this moment it is touching the bottom of our box. So make the Arduino 3D model active. Use the Move command. Move it a little bit up and write 1 millimeter. In position, capture position. Make the box bottom active again and click on home. Use this extrude command. Select everything on the bottom of our box. Press Ctrl, select also this. Pull it down by -2 millimeters. OK. Go inside of the box bottom, sketches, make it visible. Use the extrude command again. Select the edge of our box. And we are going to pull it up to the object. We are going to pull it up to the top of our PCB. So select something what is on the top of our PCB like this. Left click. and double check if it looks correct. Press OK. We are going to improve our sketch. Right click, edit. We would like to make these corners a little bit nicer. 1 millimeter. Press Ctrl, do it for all of them. And we are going to place the mounting holes for our board. Create circle, 3-point circle. Left click, left, 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 left click, and the last one is here. Escape, use this dimension tool, and we are going to make them 3.5 millimeter. 3.5. Use this offset tool around all the mounting holes. Keep it 1 millimeter. And because 1 millimeter standoff is not very strong, we are going to add some additional support. These 5 millimeter circles, which we will place close to these mounting holes into the places where are no pins on the bottom side of the PCB. So place them somewhere like this. Finish sketch. Hide the Arduino board, use the extrude, left click and press Ctrl, select all the standoffs what we have just created. Pull them up to object. I'm going to hide the box, enable the Arduino and pull them up to the bottom of the board. So again, find a place which is on the bottom of the board like this and press OK. These holes, they still don't go through the box. So use the extrude command, select the middle of the holes, press Ctrl, select all of them, and we are going to pull them down up to the bottom of the box. We are going to adjust the edges of the holes on the bottom. So use this chamber command, select all of them, press Ctrl. Here select two distances, and first one is going to be 1.5 millimeter and the other one is going to be 1.8 millimeter. Okay. We are going to add one more thing on this edge of the box. Create sketch, left click. Create, project include project, double click, OK, offset, left click, and flip, change it to minus 1.2. Okay, finish sketch. Use the extrude command, select the frame what we have just created and pull it down like minus 2 millimeters. Okay. Hide the sketch, right click, new component, call it box top. Okay. Enable 3D model of our board. Go to construct, offset plane, select the top of the connector and move this plane maybe up to 1.5 millimeter above the connector. Okay. Create sketch. Select the plane what we have just created. Create. Project include project. Enable the sketch on the bottom. Zoom in. Double click. Press Ctrl. Double click. OK. Finish sketch. Use extrude. Select the frame. Pull it down up to the bottom. OK. Go inside of the box top. Sketches. Enable the sketch. Extrude. Left click. Control left click. And pull this up like 2 millimeters. Go back to our sketch. Right click. Edit. Hide the Arduino. Create. Project include. Project. Left click. Press Ctrl. Left click. Left click. Left click. OK. Finish sketch. Hide the body of the box. Go to extrude. Left click. Press Ctrl. Left click, left click, left click, show Arduino and change this to object, pull down all these stands off down to the top of the PCB. Okay, show the bodies. And this is what we should see when we hide this Arduino. Hide the bottom part of our box. We are going to add holes into these stands off. Left click on this hole feature. Left click. Move it into center. Use 10 millimeter length and 2 millimeter hole size. Okay. Left click. Left click. Move it into center. Okay. Place it also here. And also here. We are going to make the openings for the connectors. So enable the Arduino board. Create sketch. We would like to make the openings on this side of the box. Zoom in. Hide the bodies of the top box. Create. Project include project. And select the edges of the connectors. Left click, press Ctrl, left click, left click, left click, left click, left click. Okay. To create the opening around this connector is very simple. We will use this offset tool, left click, and I'm going to make it 0.5 millimeter bigger than the connector. This one is a little bit more tricky because the real connector on the board which I have is a little bit higher. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to hide the board and I'm going to draw the opening manually. First I'm going to draw something and then we will adjust the exact size. Escape. I'm going to use this dimension tool and we would like to have distance between this and this. We would like to have it 0.5 millimeter. Same here. So from this to this, we would like to have 0.5 millimeter. And here we would like to use 1 millimeter instead. Perfect. Escape. Finish sketch. I'm going to enable the bodies. And we can make the opening. So use the extrude. Left click, control, left click, left, left. Change this to object. And left click here. Okay. Double check if everything looks okay. Perfect. Right now, this top box is created from number of different bodies. And what I would like to do, I would like to join them together. So I'm going to use this combine feature and I'm going to select everything and join them. There are some places where the board is in collision with the box. For example, here you can see this connector goes into this standoff. So what we are going to do, we are going to use this modify, combine. I'm going to select the box and the board. I'm going to change this operation to cut, keep tools, OK. I'm going to hide this Arduino board. We are going to make these cutouts a little bit bigger. Modify, offset face, freeform selection. Okay. Okay. And also there is something here. And let's make it minus 0.5. Okay. We are going to adjust this edge of our box. Click on Create Sketch, left click, Create, Project Include Project. Left click, control, left click, left click, OK. Select the lines, left click, control, left click. Use the offset tool. Change the value to minus 0.8. Okay, click on Create, Project Include Project. left click, control left click, control left, control left, OK, finish sketch. Use the extrude command, left click, control left click, and move it up like 1.5 millimeter. OK. We are going to check if everything fits perfectly. So make the whole project active, enable the board and also bottom part of our box. Go to inspect, section analysis, left click on this side of the board and move it. Okay, so there is space between connector and the top of the box. This seems to be fine. And double check this standoff. Like this. Okay. So you can see this is the bottom standoff. This is where the top standoff is finishing. There are the holes. Okay, I'm going to hide this analysis. And there is one more thing what we can do. We can add text, make the top part of our box active, click on create sketch, select the top of our box, rotate, create, text, left click, I'm going to use my company name. You can use your own. Arial black, height 9. Okay. I'm going to move it. Finish sketch. Use extrude, select the text, pull it down, and write like minus 0.5. Enter. There is one more step what we can do to completely finish this box. Make the bottom active. Go inside bodies. Now modify, combine, select the first one. Now left click on the second one, press shift, left click on the last one, and OK. We combined all the small bodies into one big body. Make the whole project active, hide this sketch, hide also this one, and this is the box what we have designed. We are going to 3D print our box, so hide the Arduino and also bottom part of our box, go to File, Export, I'm going to call it top Arduino box. For our 3D printer, we have to use STL, left click, and export. We can close this. It will continue exporting the box in the background. So just close. Now hide the top part of our box, enable the bottom part, go to File, Export, name this bottom Arduino box, select STL, export. You can see the top part has been already exported. Again, we can close this and this bottom part will be exported automatically. The software which I use for 3D printer is called Cura. I'm going to drag and drop the STL file which we have just generated from Fusion 360, select it, and we would like to flip this for better 3D printing. So I'm going to use this command and I'm going to select this. Okay. Now, these are the parameters what I use. They are some kind of default parameters. click on Slice, Preview. This is how it is going to be 3D printed. And I can save it to my SD card. Eject. Very similar way, we are going to print also the bottom part of our box. Click on File, New Print, Yes, drag and drop the bottom part of the box, Slice, Preview. This is how it is going to be 3D printed. Save it and print it. If you found this video useful, then you will make me super happy if you press the like button. If you would like to see my future videos, don't forget to subscribe. Also, leave comments and see you next time. Bye!